गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतान शृण्वन्नोतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात्परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ओम्। डियर् फ्रेण्ड्स्, वी आर् रीडिङ्ग् दिस् 13th श्लोक आफ् 13th चाप्टर्। सर्वतः पाणिपादं तत् सर्वतोक्षिशिरोमुखं सर्वतः श्रुतिमल्लोके सर्वमावृत्य तिष्ठति। सो वी रेड् दिस् श्लोक इन् द लास्ट् क्लास् and then we are somewhere in the middle, in the beginning of the bhashyam. So the purpose of this shloka is to say that there is what is called brahman, because earlier you see the sat shabda pratyaya abhishayatvat, you see this brahman is something which cannot be designated by the sat shabda, that is it exists, because there is no example in the world which you can show. So because it is satshabda vishaya agochara, that it is beyond this word called sat, so then somebody can assume that it does not exist at all. So in order to avoid that sort of understanding, then Lord Krishna is saying sarvatah paanipadam tat, what all indriyas you see, what all hands, limbs, eyes, ears, etc., of all the beings in the whole universe which we see, they are all enabled, they are all illumined by this particular Brahman. Because of that Brahma Chaitanyam, all these things are functioning. So because all these things are functioning, this is the lingam, this is the indication, this is what is indicating the presence of that Supreme Brahman. So that is what the shloka, the purpose of the shloka. So there we read the first two lines, I think. सर्वतः पाणिपादम् एट्सेट्रा एट्सेट्रा क्षेत्रोपाधिभेदकृतं विशेषजातं मिथ्यैव क्षेत्रज्ञस्य इति. सो क्षेत्रोपाधिभेदकृतं विशेषजातं, दिस् लैन् आल्सो वि रेड् इन् द लास्ट् क्लास्, दट् ईस् देर् इस् अ लाट् आफ् डिफ्रेन्स् आर् डैवर्सिटि विच् वि सी बिकास् आफ् द डैवर्सिटि आफ् द उपाधीस्. देर् आर् सो मेनी इन्यूमरबल् उपाधीस्, इन्फिनिट् नम्बर् आफ् उपाधीस् आल् ओवर् एक्सिस्टिङ्ग् फ्रम् अ स्माल् एण्ट् टु द ह्यूजेस्ट् एनिमल्. So that means millions and millions of beings in each category, in each species. So if that is so, then so much of diversity is there. But then all this diversity is not diversity in that nyaya. All this upadhi bhedakrutam vishesha jatam, all this is mithyaiva kshetrajnyasya. For that kshetrajnya, from the point of view of kshetrajnya, all these things is something which is unreal. So that is the point. मिथ्यैव क्षेत्रज्ञस्य इति तदपनयनेन ज्ञेयत्वमुक्तं न सत्तं नासदुच्यते इति. तदपनयनेन, दट् ईस् बै नेगेटिङ्ग् इट्, बै रिजेक्टिङ्ग् इट्, इट् ईस् देन् इट् वास् डिस्क्रैब्ड् एस् न सत् तत् न असत्. सो दट् इस् वाट् इट् इस् टोल्ड्. देन् उपाधिकृतम् अबौट् दिस् उपाधि हि इस् अगेन् एक्स्प्लेनिङ्ग्. उपाधिकृतं मिथ्यारूपमपि अस्तित्वाधिगमाय ज्ञेयधर्मवत् परिकल्प्य उच्यते. सो दिस् इस् वन् स्ट्राटजि विच् दि टीचर्स् आफ् वेदान्त दे फालो, दट् ईस् उपाधिकृतं मिथ्यारूपमपि. दो दिस् उपाधि, सो द ह्यूमन् बीङ्ग् इस् एन् उपाधि, ह्यूमन् मैण्ड् इस् एन् उपाधि. सिमिलर्ली एनी मैण्ड्, एनी बुद्धि आफ् एनी एनिमल्, एनी लिविङ्ग् बीङ्ग् इस् एन् उपाधि. सो आल् दिस् उपाधि, दो इट् इस् मिथ्यारूपं, सो ब्रह्मणः अस्तित्वाधिगमाय, दट् ईस् इन् आर्डर् टु कन्वे दि एक्सिस्टेन्स् आफ् दट् ब्रह्मन्, in order to convey that there is something called Brahman, astitva adhigamaya, adhigama means understanding, in order to understand the existence of that this Brahman, gneya dharmavat parikalpya uchyate, it is told as though it is gneya dharma. Why, where is it told? The first line, sarvatah paanipadam tat, that statement, that this Brahman is something which is having all these limbs and all this, sarvataha paanipadam, it is having its hands, feet, limbs everywhere, all around. So isn't it? So that is what it says. So it is a parikalpana. Parikalpya means having adhyaropa, having attributed like that, attributing what? attributing that all these things, all these limbs, hands, feet, eyes, etc., etc., they are all belonging to this Brahman. So that sort of parikalpana, that sort of visualization has been made, or attribution has been made on this Brahman. So that is the point. Sarvatah Panipadam Tat, in that line, Gneyadharmavat Parikalpya Uchyate Sarvatah Panipadam Ityadi. So then Shankaracharya was saying, he is quoting one Sampradaya Vidam Vachanam. So this we were just about to read. Let us read. Tathahi Sampradaya Vidam Vachanam Adhyaropapavadabhyam Nishprapancham Prapanchyate Iti. Okay. Tathahi, likewise, Sampradaya Vidam Vachanam. What the people who know the tradition, Sampradaya Vit means one who knows the Sampradaya is Sampradaya Vit. Sampradaya Vidam Vachanam means the statement of the people who know this Sampradaya or tradition. What do they say? They say that Adhyaropa Apavadabhyam. Adhyaropa Apavadabhyam Nishprapancham Prapanchyate. This is some traditional, very old statement. The source, is there anything mentioned about the source? I also did not check up. Not there. Okay, Adhyaropa and Apavada. So this Adhyaropa is something similar to our Adhyasa. Adhi plus Aropa. Adhi means above. Aropa means to place something. To place something on the other. To see a snake, to see a rope, and then you put a snake on that. That is Adhyaropa. If it is ignorantly done, it is Adhyasa. Sometimes the Shastra, the difference between Adhyasa and Adhyaropa is that whatever is ignorantly done is usually referred to as Adhyasa, and whatever is done in Shastra in order to say make us understand a particular point, it is called Adhyaropa. So Shastra also deliberately does some Adhyaropa now and then. So Adhyaropa can be done where some rope is there. On that, you can certainly, the snake-like thing, you can visualize anything, you can visualize. You can even visualize it as some sort of water, say, streak, or something like some break in the ground. So anything like that you can imagine. So, but there should be some little bit of similarity. So that thing will be there. It looks like that. So you are attributing that thing on something which is exactly on some other say substratum or some other adhara. There is some adhara. On that adharam you are attributing something. So that is what is called adhyaropa. Adhyasa also literally adhi is above. Asa means to be. Adhyaropa, adhyasa. Aropa means you are putting. Adhyasa means sitting, say putting or sitting on something else, that is Adhyasa. So you are ignorantly doing an Adhyasa, whereas Shastra does Adhyaropa. Then Apavada. Apavada means Vada. What is Vada? Vadadhatu, isn't it? Vadadhatu. You say something about some subject. Apavada means you retract from what you say. You say something initially and then you take back your words. So that is what is Apavada. You say something and then you take back your words. So that is what is called Apavada. So for example, this Adhyaropa and Apavada is a very important strategy, a very important way in which the existence of Brahman is conveyed. For example, you see, for a child, suppose an example given in Vedanta text is, suppose a child asks, what is the sky? How do you explain about the sky? You see the sky above is there, up above is there, and then it is blue in color. So that you say, initially that is good enough for him to understand. But then, if you want to tell further about the sky, or if he questions further about the sky, then you have to know that blueness is only some sort of light phenomena, because there is actually, really speaking, there is no blueness. It is all because of our own atmosphere, and then because of it is a phenomenon of light. It is appearing blue, it is not otherwise blue. So it is so infinitely expanding. It is something which is there infinitely. So something like that you have to explain. So what you have told earlier, that sky is blue, you are taking back. So like that, the text also does the same thing. For example, if you remember Taittiriya Upanishad, Taittiriya of course we have not read, we are going to study that. What does it say? ఇట్ టాక్స్ అబౌట్ ఆకాశాద్ వాయు వాయురగ్ని అగ్నేరాపహ ఎట్సెట్రా ఎట్సెట్రా ఇట్ సేస్ ఓకే దేర్ ఈస్ సమ్ సుప్రీం బ్రహ్మన్ తస్మాద్వాయే తస్మాదాత్మన ఆకాశ సంభూత సో ఫ్రమ్ దట్ సుప్రీం ఆత్మన్ సే దట్ ఆకాశ ఇట్ అపియర్డ్ సో ద ఫ్రమ్ దట్ ఆకాశ ఆకాశాద్ వాయు ఎయిర్ కేమ్ అండ్ దెన్ ఫ్రమ్ ఎయిర్ అగ్ని కేమ్ ఫ్రమ్ అగ్ని ఇట్ కేమ్ సమ్ వాటర్ ఆర్ సంథింగ్ లైక్ దట్ సో ఇట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ డిస్క్రైబింగ్ దెన్ వై ఈజ్ ఇట్ డిస్క్రైబింగ్ Then ultimately when you see the whole Bhashyam, you see that all this thing is again taken back. All the words about what all has been told about creation, they are all taken back. And then it is basically to show that except Brahman there is nothing. So you see, we have not, Shastra is not deliberately making an Adhyaropa. In the sense that, say, they don't want actually. But then we have made that Adhyaropa, so Shastra also has to follow that Adhyaropa in order to make us understand. You see, if you say, if Shastra directly says that Brahman is something which is Satyam, Jnanam, Anantam, etc., etc., we will not be able to comprehend. So that is why Shastra has to come along with you to some extent and then slowly divert you. Shastra is running along with us to some extent and then it is slowly diverting us. So that is what Shastra does. So we all believe that there is a Srishtikarta. We all believe that there is somebody who is sitting in the sky, somebody who is taking out some material and then somebody who is preparing this earth, etc. Somebody who has made a man in his own image and things like that. So all religions, they talk about that. So because we have all this belief, so the Vedanta also has to come along with us to some extent and then slowly tell us, you just see what is the karya karana sambandha. So Vedanta adopts the strategy of explaining the karya karana sambandha. You take a pot and then you say, how is this pot made? It is made of clay. So can you see this pot apart from the clay? You just rotate it all around and then see whether you can see it apart from the clay. You cannot see it apart from the clay. So similarly, you see your own body-mind complex, how it has evolved. Your mind has evolved from the sattvika tanmatra of the pancha, the five elements. Then my sense of touch has evolved from the sattvika tanmatra of some air or something like that. Sattvika tanmatra, sparsha. Sparsha, air. Then taste, my sense of taste has evolved from the sattvika tanmatra, water. So something like that. All these things, they are corresponding. So then what you think as your shrotra is nothing but sky. What you think that it is your tvak is nothing but, air. What you think that it is your sense of smell is nothing but water. So what you think of your physical body is nothing but the panchabhutas. This is rajoguna, tamoguna, santa panchabhutas. Then what you think about your body and indriyas, sense organs, it is nothing but the sattvamsha of the same, five elements. So you have dismissed this body-mind complex. And then you have gone to the level of karana. So you have dismissed this body-mind complex and then you have gone to the level of karana. So that is, there is another word in Shastra for that. It is called pravilapana. The Taittiriya Upanishad also uses the word pravilapya, pravilapya. Pravilapya means having dissolved one into another. Pravilapa, having merged something into the other. So instead of seeing the pot, you are seeing the clay. So like that, instead of seeing the eye, you are seeing that element of fire. Instead of seeing something, sense of taste, you are seeing that water. So instead of seeing the body-mind complex, you are seeing the panchabhutas. Both tanmatras and also panchabhutas, physical bhutas. So that is one level of pravilapana. Then the next level, what exactly are panchabhutas? Again, this sattva-rajas tamoguna parinama only. So you do pravilapana in that sattva-rajas tamogunas. You dissolve them in that sattva-rajas tamoguna. Then again, what is sattva-rajas tamoguna? Sattva-rajas tamoguna is nothing but maya. It is just, they are from the maya only. So it is maya only. That is avyakta. And avyakta itself is an appearance in that Brahman. Brahma Chaitanya only, in that appearance, this maya is there. So from this karya, that is from this effect, you are discarding one after the other and slowly you are going up. So that is what Taittiriya Upanishad also says about Annamaya Kosha, Pranamaya Kosha, Manomaya Kosha, Vijnanamaya Kosha. He rejects Bhrugu, Bhruguvalli. Bhrugu rejects one Kosha. Kosha means a sheath, one level, let us say. One level of understanding he rejects. He goes to the next level of understanding. Then he rejects that. It is something like from 5th class you come to 6th class. Then 6th class to 10th class, 10th class to, say, a college, again college to postgraduate, something like that. So, you go beyond this. Reject means, of course in Vedanta we say reject. They say you go beyond this. You go beyond this and see the reality. So, that is apavada. Apavada means you are retracting from what you have said earlier. Initially you have said Akasha, Advayu, Vayu, Agni, etc., etc. You have given that process of evolution. Then you are going back and then say that this being whom you call I is nothing but that Supreme Brahman which has originated from that, or which is another form of that. So this is what is called Adhyaropa and Apavada. So Shastra does it in order to make us understand. Shastra, it is one of the important strategies. Adhyaropa Apavada is one of the methods. One of the methods to make us understand and then reject the Karya aspect and then going back to Karana. Is it fairly okay? So this is what is Adhyaropa and Apavada. So then one question may come. Why should Shastra do Adhyaropa at all? And then why should it do Apavada? So Nilakantha Vyakya, there is a small line about that. I will read out that line also. So as I said, why should you get into some dirt and then why wash it? There is a saying in Sanskrit. So Nilakanthacharya writes, Nanu prakshalanadhi pankasya durad asparshanam varamiti nyayena vyarthaha tarhi karanopanyasaha iti chet. So he says, prakshalanadhi pankasya. That you see, you have stepped into some mud. You have stepped into some slush. After having stepped into that or rolled in mud, then again you want to wash it. First of all, why don't you avoid that mud at all? Why don't you avoid that slush? So that is the question. Why should you do Adhyaropa? And then why should you do Apavada? So then the reply is, na. It is not so. Tam vina shuddha adhigama ayogat. You see, you cannot understand this Shuddha Brahman. Shuddha Adhigama, that is understanding this Shuddha Brahman. That understanding this Shuddha Brahman is not possible unless you walk along with him to some extent and then slowly divert him. You have to walk along with the loka. You have to walk along with the common man and then you slightly divert him. So straight away if you say the human mind, humankind cannot bear too much of reality, there is one saying. There is one saying, one English poet has said, humankind cannot bear too much of reality. So if you say that it is all existence, consciousness and things like that, the man will not understand. He will not bother. He will think that we are mad. So that is why slowly you have to walk along with him, tell him to some extent and then slowly divert him. So he says, Shakha Chandra Nyayena hi Sagunam Nirgunasya Vastunaha Jnapakam. Sagunam is nirgunasya vastunaha jnapakam. This saguna which you are talking about. So this saguna brahma level which we are talking about, or a god as we are talking about, is something which is a jnapakam for that nirguna. Jnapakam means something which leads you there. Jnapti. Jnapti means memory. So recalling. So this saguna brahma will make you recall, will make you realize. Jnapakam. That is, it will make you realize. Or it will make you understand that Nirguna Brahma. So this Saguna level, we can't close it there and then say, okay, this my God is the final God, my heaven is the ultimate heaven, you can't close it like that. So this Saguna Brahma is only a level. This Saguna Brahma is only a sort of means through which you attain higher. You have to understand the Nirguna level. So that is what is a good line from Nilakantha Vyakhya. So, this line, did you understand? Adhyar, Adhyaropa, Apavada, Abhyam, Nishprapancham, Prapanchyate. This Prapancham, we know, Nishprapancham means Nirvishesham, where there is no Vishesha. Pachidhatu, last time also I think somewhere we got it. Pachidhatu, Pachi means Vyaktikarane. So prapancha means to elaborately say, to something like vyakarana. So to make it elaborate, to expand, to elaborate, that is what is prapancha. So nishprapancha means where there is nothing, where there is no vishesha. Only when there is vishesha, you can make it elaborate, when there is no vishesha. So this nishprapancham prapanchyate, that is, though it is nirvishesha, it is shown as savishesha. So this adhyaropa apavadabhyam, by this strategy of this adhyaropa and apavada, this nishprapancha brahma, this brahman without any sort of attributes, is prapanchyate, means explained. It is vyaktikarana, pachidhatu vyaktikarana, isn't it? It is properly explained. So that is it. Then let us read the next line. Sarvatra sarva dehavayavatvena gamyamanaha.
ज्ञेयस्य इति उपचारतः उच्यन्ते.
Okay, so here again, okay, this sarvatah panipadam, etc., is again explaining. Sarvatra sarvadehavayavatvena gamyamanah panipadadayah. You see, this hands, limbs, and all other organs, etc., etc., which are appearing as sarvadehavayavatvena, that is, as the avayavas, as the limbs of all the beings, of all the beings which we see, all these things, they are deriving their existence only because of the Jnaya Shakti. They are Panipadadayaha, Jnaya Shakti Sadbhava Nimitta Svakaryaha. Their Svakarya, Svakarya means their own activity. It is due to Nimitta. Nimitta means Karanam, reason. Svakarya is their activity. Nimittam, Nimittam is reason. Reason is due to what? Jnaya Shakti Sadbhava. The existence of this Jnaya Shakti. Sadbhava means existence. You can note down. This is again a long bahurihi. Jnaya Shakti Sadbhava Nimitta Svakaryaha is a very, very long bahurihi. That is, all the activities are due to Nimitta. Jnaya Shakti Sadbhava is the Nimitta for all these karyas, for all the karyas of all these limbs, of all these organs. Is that only language we have to understand, but otherwise the meaning is this. All the limbs of all these things which we are seeing, they are actually activated. They are functioning only because of the Jnaya Shakti. Jnaya Shakti means that Shuddha Chaitanya. Because of that Chaitanya only, all these things are able to function. Svakarya iti, Jnaya Sadbhave Lingani. Sadbhava, I said, what is Sadbhava?
Existence.
Jnaya Sadbhava, we should not confuse it as Sadbhava, Durbhava, goodwill, badwill, it's not like that. Sadbhava means existence. Jnaya Sadbhave Lingani. Linga means indication. Linga is an indication. So all these things are indication. So we know the example of electricity. The indication that there is electricity are so many gadgets. Right now there is no electricity. We don't have all these lights and other gadgets except this thing. So Jnaya Sadbhave Lingani. But Jnayasya iti upacharataha uchyante, only figuratively we are saying that upacharataha, we know upachara, with the word upachara we know aupacharika prayoga. Upachara means figurative. Figuratively, Jnayasya iti uchyante, they are being told that they belong to Jnaya. So we are only figurative, this line, sarvatah panipadam, is something, it is upacharataha. Only figuratively you are saying. For you know, basically following the principle of adhyaropa and apavada. Following the principle of adhyaropa and apavada, we are saying that this is sarvatah panipadam, sarvato akshishiromukham, sarvatah shrutimat, etc., etc. All this we are attributing. We are saying that this jnaya is having all these things. Though jnaya is not having any of these things, jnaya is only illumining all that. Jnaya Sadbhave Lingani, all these things are indicative of the presence of some consciousness which is illumining them. So that is the meaning there. Jnaya Sethi Upacharataha Ucchyante. Tatha Vyakheyam अन्यत् सर्वतः पाणिपादं पर सर्वतः पाणिपादं तत् ज्ञेयम् सर्वतोक्षिशिरोमुखम् सर्वत्र अक्षीणी शिरांसि मुखानि यस्य सर्वतोक्षिशिरोमुखम् सर्वतः श्रुतिमत् श्रुतिः श्रवणेन्द्रियम् तद् यस्य तत् श्रुतिमत् लोके प्राणिनिकाये सर्वं आवृत्य संव्याप्य तिष्ठति स्थितिं लभते. सो वन्स यू हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड वन पद इट इज ईजी टू एक्सप्लेन अदर पदस बिकॉज वन पद ग्रेट एलैबोरेट डिस्कशन हैज टेकन प्लेस. फॉर दिस निर्गुण ब्रह्मन हाउ आर यू गोइंग टू एट्रीब्यूट सो मेनी लिम्स एंड ऑल दैट. All this is by upachara, all this is by way, it's a sort of figurative usage, only in a figurative manner we are saying that, but otherwise really speaking Brahman is not having any of these things, so we have concluded. So once we have explained one line, it applies to all other things also. Sarvataha akshi shiromukham, what is this sarvataha, tatha vyakheyam, anyat sarvataha panipadam tatnyayam, okay. All other things, tatha vyakheyam means, other things have to be similarly commented upon. Vyakhyayam means it has to be commented upon like that. It has to be explained like that. What? Sarvataha akshimukha shiromukham. Sarvatra akshini shiramsi mukhani. All over you have got all the eyes, shiramsi, heads, mukhani, faces or mouths, whatever it is. Mukhani jayasya tat sarvatoshimukha shiromukham. Then similarly sarvataha shrutimat. Shrutimat means Shruti, he means Shrotrendriyam. Shankaracharya sometimes, we know that he explains small, small words also. Shruti hi Shravanendriyam. Shruti means Shravanendriyam, this sense organ. So that which is having that sense organ is called Shruti Mat. Tad yasya tad Shruti Mat. Loke. Loke means in this world. Prani Nikaye. Nikaya means a large group, a multitude, let us say, a great in this multitude of humanity. Let us say, Prani Nikaya, okay, this not only humanity, multitude of living beings, all pranis, multitude of living beings, sarvam avrutya samvyapya. So having pervaded, avrutya, having pervaded, having permeated everything, samvyapya, tishthati, sthitim labhate, it exists. Sthitim labhate means it exists. Then there is a small avatarika for the next single line avatarika. उपाधिभूत पाणिपादादि इंद्रियाध्यारोपणात् इंद्रियाध्यारोपणात् ज्ञेयस्य तद्वत्ताशंका माभूत् इत्येवमर्थः श्लोकारम्भः. सो उपाधिभूत पाणिपादादि so you see what have we done in this earlier line and the earlier shloka, all this pani pada etc etc, all this pani pada etc, indriya adhyaropanat, we have done adhyaropa on this Brahman. But because we have done adhyaropa, somebody may think that this all this thing is really true. Gyayasya tadvattashanka. Tadvattashanka means gyaya is really having all these things. Gyaya is really tadvan or tadvat. Gnyayam, of course, we are now talking about Napumsakalinga, neuter gender. So, gnyayam is tadvat. Tadvat means it is having all these qualities. Sarvatah panipadam, sarvatoshi shurvamukam, tadvat. Tadvat means matuparthakam. Tadvat means that which is having all this. So, tadvatta means that state of having all these things. Tadvatta is noun form. So, tadvatta ashanka is becomes tadvatta ashanka. Means a doubt that the gnyaya is really having all these things. Some such doubt may arise in somebody's mind. So that is why Lord Krishna himself is doing apavada. So that is what Shankaracharya is explaining. Tadvatta shanka mabhut. Mabhut means let that shanka not be there. Mabhut. Let it not be there. May it not be there. So that is what is the meaning of mabhut. Iti ityevam artha shloka arambha. Let us read this next shloka. सर्वेन्द्रियगुणाभासम् सर्वेन्द्रियविवर्जितम् असक्तम् सर्वभृत्चैव निर्गुणम् गुणभोक्तृच ओके सो सर्वेन्द्रियगुणाभासम् विल सी दि श्लोक सर्व इंद्रिय गुण आभास आभास मीन्स आभास एक्चुअली मीन्स एन अपीयरेंस इट इज नॉट रियली देयर इट्स एन अपीयरेंस आभास लाइक कर्माभास वी नो दट वर्ड कर्माभास वट एवर वट एवर कर्म ए ज्ञानी डज इट इज नॉट इट इज कर्म इट इज कर्म आभास इट अपीयर्स लाइक ए कर्म सो हियर ऑल्सो सर्वेन्द्रिय गुण आभास It is appearing as though it is having the guna. Guna means characteristics of all these indriyas. Sarva indriya guna abhasa. So it is there is an appearance that it is having the gunas of all these indriyas. That is sarvendriya guna abhasam. But then sarvendriya vivarjitam. It is something which is devoid of all the vivarjitam. Varjana. Varjana means to reject. Sarvendriya vivarjitam. We know this word. Varjyam. Varjyam we say. Today there is a varjyam from this hour to this hour. So that is varjana means to avoid. Sarvendriya vivarjitam is something which is devoid of any of these indriyas. Then asaktam, that which does not have a sangha. From the word sangha only, asaktam. Sangha plus kta becomes asakta. Sakta. So na plus sakta is asakta. That is something which does not have any association. It is not attached to anything. Asanga. Brahman is supposed to be asanga. Because Brahman is something of the pure consciousness. It cannot have any sangam with anything. It is something like a pure light which illumines everything. It does not have any connection with anything. Asanga. Asaktam. Then at the same time, sarvabhrut chaiva. Sarvabhrut. Bhrut means sarvam vibharti. Sarvam vibharti iti sarvabhrut. That which bears, that which sustains, that which supports, everything is sarvabhrut. Bhrut, bhru, bhru dhatu, bharanam. Bharanam, you know, bhru, to bear, the English word bear, that is the same thing, sarvabhrut. That which bears everything, that which sustains or supports everything is sarvabhrut. So this is all a sort of paradoxical statement. So on one side it is appearing as though it is having gunas, but at the same time it is not having any indriyas. Then asaktam, that is something which is unattached to anything, but at the same time it is supporting everything. So it looks paradoxical. Sarvabhrutchaiva. Then nirgunam, this is something which is nirgunam, devoid of any attributes, but at the same time gunabhoktrucha. Gunabhoktru. Bhoktru means that which is enjoying everything. Gunabhoktru. Bhokta shabda, you know, bhokta is pumlinga. Bhoktru is napumsakalinga. Bhoktru is the original word. Then that is a napumsakalinga. Bhokta becomes pumlinga. Bhoktri becomes strilinga. So guna bhoktru means that which is able to perceive everything. That which is able to know everything. Which means again by upachara only. Gyanasya iti upacharta uchyante virat. So all these things is by upachara. So whatever we are attributing as guna bhokta, then sarvabhrut. Then God, all-powerful, omniscient, omnipotent, etc., etc. It is all by upachara we are saying. Not really so. So that is the point here. So nirgunam guna bhoktrucha. Guna bhokta, you understood?
Yes, sir.
Bhokta means one who eats. One who eats is bhokta, isn't it? One who, we hear guna bhoktru means one who experiences by various organs, by all these sense organs, that which is experiencing all these. So that is what is guna bhoktru. So though it is devoid of any of these gunas, it is looking as though it is guna bhoktru. So that is how we have to understand this. Though it is asanga, it is looking as though it is the sustainer, it is the supporter of all. So that is apavada. So Krishna himself is doing apavada here. So let us see the bhashyam. Sarvendriya gunabhasam.
Sarvendriya gunabhasam.
Sarvani cha tani indriyani shrotradini. बुद्धि इंद्रिय कर्मेंद्रियाख्यानि कर्मेंद्रियाख्यानि अंतःकरणे च बुद्धिमनसि ज्ञेयोपाधित्वस्य तुल्यत्वात् सर्वेन्द्रियग्रहणेन गृह्यते ओके सो सर्वेन्द्रिय गुणाभासम् सो ही इज एक्सप्लेनिंग दैट सेंटेंस दैट फ्रेज सर्वाणि च तानि इन्द्रियाणि सर्वाणि सर्व प्लस इंद्रिय सर्वाणि चितानि इंद्रियाणि ऑल दीस से इंद्रियस सेंस ऑर्गन्स व्हाट आर दे श्रोत्र आदीनि सेंस ऑफ हियरिंग एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा देन हियर स्पेसिफिकली दिस बुद्धि एंड मनस हैव नॉट बीन मेंशनड हियर वी आर इन द श्लोक वी आर सीइंग ओनली इंद्रियस So Shankaracharya, he is including this buddhi manas because without this buddhi and manas, where do indriyas come? So you see, I am just sitting here. My mind is elsewhere, but in front of me there are so many objects. You put something, there is so many things, but my mind has not even cognized them. So my sense, my eye is actually looking at it, but it is not cognizing. So unless there is a mind, all these indriyas are of no use. So mind has to be told, mind and buddhi, buddhi and manas, both have to be included. So that is why Shankaracharya is including. You see, buddhi in the shrotra adini, buddhi indriya karmendriya khyani. So for that indriya, Shankaracharya is taking the meaning of not only this sense organs, he is also taking buddhi and manas. So that is why he says buddhi indriya karmendriya akhyani, those which are called akhya means called, that which is called, that which are known as buddhi indriya and karmendriya. That is buddhi indriya, in that buddhi indriya he is also making again classification, antahkaranecha buddhi manasi, they are buddhi and manas, buddhi manasi dvivachanam, buddhi manasi antahkarane, antahkaranam antahkarane. So again, that is again a dvivachanam. So this buddhi and manas, they are the internal organs. These two are the internal organs. Then they are also upadhi. So that is what he is saying. Jnyeyopadhitvasya tulyatvat sarvendriya grahanena gruhyate. So this jnyeyopadhitvam is tulyam. Tulyam means it is common. It is common to buddhi and manas also. What is common? Jnyeyopadhitvam, that these things are also upadhis for the jnyeya. You see, and the indriyas, we know they are all the upadhi for jnyeya. So similarly, it is not only the indriya, shrotram, chakshu, etc. Not only they are the upadhis, buddhi and manas are also upadhis. In fact, buddhi and manas are the primary upadhis. So that is what Shankaracharya is going to say. Without buddhi and manas, you will not be able to know things. You will not be able to hear. Sometimes there is some music going on, but my mind is elsewhere. My mind is not at all on the music. So something like that. So, jnyeyopadhitvasya tulyatvat means they are also upadhi to jnyayam. They are also upadhi to jnayam. That is a common factor there. Common factor between what? Common factor between the indriyas and buddhi manasi. So because of that, sarvendriya grahanena gruhyate. So by this sarvendriya shabda, they are also included. In that sarvendriya shabda, buddhi, manas are also included along with the other indriyas, shrotrendriya, etc. Then apicha antahkaranopadhidvarena iva shrotradinamapi upadhitvam
अध्यवसाय संकल्प श्रवण वचनादिभिः अवभासत इति सर्वेन्द्रिय गुणाभासम्.
So, Sarvendriya, he told earlier, now he is telling about the whole word Sarvendriya Guna Abhasam. Apicha, moreover, we should also see that. Apicha means, moreover, we have to see that. Antahkaranopadhidvarenaiva, that is, as I said just now, it is only when this antahkarana is there, only then the other senses become meaningful, other senses become relevant. When there is no antahkarana, then all the senses will not make any relevance. So antahkarana is what is called, here I think one commentator, Bellamkonda Ramaraya Kavi, he says, antahkaranam is the sannihita upadhi. Sannihita upadhi which is more proximate upadhi. And then this shrotra, indriya, etc., they are not so proximate. They are slightly remote when compared to mind. Mind and buddhi are proximate upadhis, direct upadhis, let us say. And then these indriyas are slightly indirect upadhis, slightly remote upadhis. So that's how we have to understand. अंतःकरण उपाधि द्वारेणैव मीन्स इट इज ओनली थ्रू दिस अंतःकरण विच इज दिस उपाधि श्रोत्रादीनामपि उपाधित्वम् The upadhitvam or the fact that the shrotra etc. are the upadhis, it is possible only because antahkarana is there. Without antahkarana, these things will not be upadhis. Upadhitvam ityataha antahkarana bahishkarana upadhibhutaihi sarvendriya gunaihi. So we are now talking about antahkarana bahishkarana. Antahkarana, that is mind buddhi, bahishkarana, these indriya sense organs, and upadhibhutaihi. So for them again there are upadhis. What are those upadhis? Sarvendriya gunaihi. So there is what is called indriya gunas. So that is indriya, all these indriyas, adhyavasaya, sankalpa, shravana, vachana, etc. These are all the gunas. These are all the functions, let us say here. Guna, it is referring to functions here. So what are those functions? Adhyavasaya. Adhyavasaya is the function of buddhi. Adhyavasayatmika buddhi, isn't it? Then sankalpa. Manas sankalpatmika manaha, isn't it? So manas is sankalpatmika. So all these functions, adhyavasaya, sankalpa, shravana, vachana. Shravana is shrotrendriyam, vachana is vagindriyam. Vagindriyam is organ of action. Shrotrendriyam is organ of sense. So he is including all these organs, including the antahkarana and bahishkarana and also their functions. All these things, with all these things, avabhasate. Avabhasate means it is appearing. What? This Brahman is appearing with all these things. Sarvendriya gunabhasam. Is it clear? Or because only this language we have to slightly break, that's all. Sarvendriya gunabhasam. Then sarvendriya vyaparaihi vyaprutamiva. Did we read this?
No.
Okay, let us read. Avabhasata iti. Then
sarvendriya vyaparaihi vyaprutamiva tad jneyam ityartha. So
it is tat jneyam, that jneyam. What is that jneyam? That Brahman, it is looking as though sarvendriya vyaparaihi vyaprutamiva, it is looking as though it is engaged with the activities of all these organs. Vyaprutam. Vyaprutam means engaged, busy. It is so busy. Vyaprutam. Vyapara, you know. Vyapara means activity. Vyaprutam means something which is busy. So that it is looking as though it is so engaged, so busy with all these indriya vyaparas. Sarvendriya vyaparaihi. With all these indriya vyaparas, with all the activities of all these indriyas, this ajnayam is looking as though it is engaged, it is so busy with all these things. Then he is quoting one shruti, dhyayativa lelayativa iti shrutehe.
Dhyayativa lelayativa iti shrutehe.
So this dhyayativa lelayativa, that is dhyayati iva. So when the mind is thinking, when the mind is meditating on something, you may be meditating on anything, not necessarily on God, you may be meditating on your bank account, you may be meditating on somebody else. So you may be thinking. So when you are thinking, this jnayam, this intelligence or this consciousness, it is also looking as though it is also thinking. Lelayativa, when you are moving about or when your mind is wavering, when your mind is wavering or when you are physically moving about, that consciousness also is looking as though it is moving about. Dhyayativa lelayativa. So you can again take the example of this Jalasurya. Jalasurya example is given by Nilakanta. Nilakanta also has written a beautiful commentary here. So Jalasurya. So Jalasurya, you know, Jalasurya means Surya, the sun which is getting reflected in various water bodies. And suppose in some water body the water is shaking. When the water is shaking, the sun also, this appears shaking. But in reality, the sun is not shaking. So jalasuryavat. So like that, this consciousness also looking as though engaged in so many bodies, engaged in so many indriyas, and then it is looking as though it is moving along with them, as though it is shaking. Dhyayativa lelayativa, it is moving as though. So you take some water bodies and then shake and then try to see the image, this is reflection of the sun. The sun also will look, it will be shaking. Or you throw some stone into a pond and then the sun's, because of this ripples and all that, whether it is a sun or moon, that also appears shaking. So it is like that. So like that, it appears as though it is connected with all these things. सो व्यापृतमिव तद्ज्ञेयं ध्यायतीव लीलायतीव इति श्रुतेः देन्
कस्मात् पुनः कारणात्
न व्यापृतम् एव इति गृह्यते इत्यतः आह सो वट् डिड् वि सी इन् दि अर्लियर् लैन् व्यापृतम् इव वि सेड् व्यापृतम् इव मीन्स् एस् दो इट् इस् लुकिङ्ग् एस् दो इट् इस् अटाच् दट् इव अण्ड् एव यु प्लीस् नोट् व्यापृतम् इव देन् देर् इस् अ क्वश्चन् कस्मात् पुनः कारणात् व्यापृतमेव इति न गृह्यते वै डोण्ट् यु से दट् इट् इस् व्यापृतम् इट् इस् इण्डीड् व्यापृतं व्यापृतमेव मीन्स् इट् इस् इण्डीड् व्यापृतम् इट् इस् इण्डीड् कनेक्टेड् वित् दट् इट् इस् इण्डीड् असोसियेटेड् वित् आल् दट् वै डोण्ट् यु से दट् इत्यतः सर्वेन्द्रियविवर्जितम् सर्वकरणरहितम् इत्यर्थः अतः न करणव्यापारैः व्यापृतं तत् ज्ञेयम् सो द वेरि नेक्स्ट् सेण्टेन्स् इस् निगेटिङ्ग् द वेरि नेक्स्ट् सेण्टेन्स् इस् रिट्राक्टिङ्ग् अध्यारोप अपवाद अध्यारोप अपवाद अपवाद मीन्स् negating or retracting what you have said. So once you have said sarvendriya gunabhasam, then you said sarvendriya vivarjitam, then so sarvendriya vivarjitam sarva karana rahitam, that is karanam is indriyam, sense organs, all the, well, it can be sense organ or motor organs. So sar indriya rahitam, rahitam means which is devoid, then ataha na karana vyaparaihi vyaprutam, that jnayam, it is not busy, it is not really attached, it is not really engaged with any of these karana vyaparas. Then yastvayam mantraha apanipado javanograhita pashyat yachakshuhu स शृणोत्यकर्णः इत्यादि इत्यादिः सः सर्वेन्द्रियोपाधिगुणानुगुण्य भजनशक्तिमत् तत् ज्ञेयमित्येवं प्रदर्शनार्थः न तु साक्षादेव जवनादिक्रियावत्त्वप्रदर्शनार्थः प्रदर्शनार्थः. सो देर् इस् अ मन्त्र, यस्तु अयं मन्त्रः, ओके यु मे कोट् वन् मन्त्र, वाट् इस् दट् मन्त्र? अपाणिपादः जवनो ग्रहीत, इट् इस् संथिङ्ग् लैक् तदेजति तन्नैजति तद्दूरे तद्वन्तिके विश्वरेडि नीशावश्योपनिषत्. इट् मूव्स्, इट् मूव्स् नाट्, इट् इस् फार् अवे, इट् इस् नियर् अण्ड् देन् तदन्तरस्य तद् सर्वस्यास्य बाह्यतः, संथिङ्ग् लैक् दट्. इट् इस् देर् इन् एव्रिथिङ्ग्, इट् इस् देर् औट्सैड् एव्रिथिङ्ग्, सो इट् इस् संथिङ्ग् लैक् दट्. अपाणिपादः, देर् इस् अ डिस्क्रिप्शन् आफ् दिस् ब्रह्मन्. अपाणिपादः, दिस् ब्रह्मन् इस् संथिङ्ग् विच् डस् नाट् हेव् एनी आफ् दीस् लिम्स्, बट् अट् द सेम् टैम् जवनः, जवनः मीन्स् something like javan, we know this javan. What is javan? Javanah, java means speed, javanah means speedy, it moves fast. Java, java sattvalu we say, java, java is speed. That of course javan is different, that comes from the root yuvanah, yuva, yuvanav, yuvanah, that's a different thing. This java is slightly closely related. Java means fast, fast and furious, let us say. So javanah. Grahita, grahita means that which can grab a thing, that which takes, that which holds. Graha, grubhnati, grab, that which holds a thing, that which takes a thing. Javanaha grahita, pashyati achakshuhu, achakshuhu means though there are no eyes, achakshuhu, though there are no eyes, pashyati, it sees, pashyati achakshuhu. Then sashrunoti akarnaha, though there are no ears, it is shrunoti. So these are all paradoxical statements which we have to see, which we have seen all these paradoxical statements in the earlier Upanishads also. So this is sarvendriya upadhi. Then how should it be understood? It has to be understood in this way. He is saying ityadihi saha, that means ityadi, that brahman, it has to be understood like this. How sarvendriyopadhi gunanugunya bhajana shaktimat tat gneyam. So tat gneyam, that jnayam which is Brahman, it is having so much of shakti. What type of shakti? Sarvendriya upadhi gunanugunya bhajanam. So it is capable of assuming the shape or assuming the semblance of సర్వేంద్రియ ఉపాధి గుణ. ఓకే, సో ఆల్ దీస్ ఇంద్రియాస్ ఆర్ ఉపాధిస్. వినో, లెట్ అస్ బ్రేక్ దిస్ వర్డ్ సర్వ ఇంద్రియ ఉపాధి. ఆల్ ది ఇంద్రియాస్ విచ్ ఆర్ ఉపాధిస్, దే ఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ సమ్ క్యారెక్టరిస్టిక్స్. దే ఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ సమ్ క్యారెక్టరిస్టిక్స్ మీన్స్ ఐ ఈజ్ ఏబుల్ టు సీ, ది ఇయర్ ఈజ్ ఏబుల్ టు హియర్, సెండ్ మై నోస్ ఈజ్ ఏబుల్ టు స్మెల్. ఆల్ దీస్ ఆర్ గుణాస్. సో విత్ ఆల్ దీస్ గుణాస్ అనుగుణ్య భజన శక్తిమత్. అనుగుణ్య మీన్స్ వీ నో దిస్ అనుగుణం, అనుగుణంగా ఉంది విషయం ఇన్ తెలుగు ఆల్సో. అనుగుణం మీన్స్ ఇన్ అకార్డెన్స్ విత్. అనుగుణ్య భజనం మీన్స్ టు బీ ఇన్ అకార్డెన్స్ విత్, టు బికమ్ ఆర్ టు అజ్యూమ్ ఆర్ టు రిజెంబుల్ సే దోస్ థింగ్స్. అనుగుణ్య భజనం మీన్స్ టు బీ ఇన్ అకార్డెన్స్ విత్ ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్. యు సీ ది శ్రోత్రం ఈజ్ ఏబుల్ టు హియర్, ఇజంట్ ఇట్? సో దిస్ దిస్ తత్ జ్ఞేయం బ్రహ్మ, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఆల్సో లుకింగ్ యాజ్ దో ఇట్ ఈస్ నథింగ్ బట్ శ్రోత్రం. ఇట్ ఈస్ సో మిక్స్డ్ అప్ విత్ దట్, దిస్ కాన్షియస్నెస్ ఈస్ సో మిక్స్డ్ అప్ విత్ అవర్ మైండ్ అండ్ సెన్సెస్ దట్ వీఆర్ నాట్ ఏబుల్ టు డిస్టింగ్విష్. అనుగుణ్య భజనం, దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈస్ దట్. భజన డస్ నాట్ మీన్ భజన ఆఫ్ ఎనీథింగ్, భజ ధాతు వినో. భజ మీన్స్ టు బికమ్ టు అజ్యూమ్ టు అజ్యూమ్ దట్ షేప్. సో సే సో అండ్ సో రూపం భజతి, లెట్ అస్ సే రూపం భజతి మీన్స్ ఇట్ అజ్యూమ్స్ దట్ షేప్. సో భజ ధాతు హ్యాస్ సెవరల్ మీనింగ్స్ డిపెండింగ్ ఆన్ ద కాంటెక్స్ట్. సో అనుగుణ్య భజనం, సో దట్ ఈస్ ఇట్ కెన్ అజ్యూమ్ ద సెంబ్లెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ద గుణాస్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ దీస్ ఇంద్రియాస్. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద శక్తి ఆఫ్ దిస్ జ్ఞేయం. దిస్ జ్ఞేయం విచ్ ఈస్ నథింగ్ బట్ కాన్షియస్నెస్, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఏబుల్ టు అజ్యూమ్ ద గుణాస్. ఇట్ ఈస్ ఏబుల్ టు లుక్ లైక్ ఎ శ్రోత్రం, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఏబుల్ టు లుక్ లైక్ శ్రవణం, సారీ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఏబుల్ టు లుక్ లైక్ చక్షు, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఏబుల్ టు లుక్ లైక్ నోస్, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఏబుల్ టు అపియర్ లైక్ మైండ్, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఏబుల్ టు అపియర్ లైక్ బుద్ధి. సో ఇట్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ ది గుణాస్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్, ఇట్ ఈస్ లుకింగ్ యాజ్ దో ఇట్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ ద గుణాస్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్. ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ హ్యావింగ్, ఇట్ ఈస్ లుకింగ్ యాజ్ దో ఇట్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ ద గుణాస్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్. ఇట్ ఈస్ అజ్యూమింగ్ ది సెంబ్లెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ దీస్ సే ఆర్గన్స్, అజ్యూమింగ్ ది సెంబ్లెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ద గుణాస్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ దీస్ ఆర్గన్స్. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ సర్వేంద్రియ గుణోపాధి గుణానుగుణ్య భజన శక్తిమత్. ఇస్ అగైన్ నపుంసకలింగాంతం. శక్తిమత్ మీన్స్ దట్ విచ్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ దట్ శక్తి, దట్ విచ్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ దట్ కెపాసిటీ. దట్ కాన్షియస్నెస్ ఈజ్ హ్యావింగ్ దట్ కెపాసిటీ టు అపియర్ యాజ్ దో ఇట్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ ద గుణాస్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ దీస్ ఇంద్రియాస్. సో ఇన్ సింపుల్ దట్ ఈస్ ఇట్. కాన్షియస్నెస్ ఈజ్ హ్యావింగ్ దట్ శక్తి టు అపియర్ యాజ్ దో ఇట్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ ఆల్ ద గుణాస్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ దీస్ ఇంద్రియాస్. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ దట్. సో తద్ జ్ఞేయం ఇత్యేవం ప్రదర్శనార్థః. సో దిస్ అబౌ లైన్ విచ్ ఈస్ దట్ అపాణిపాదః జపనః గ్రహీత ఎట్సెట్రా ఎట్సెట్రా, ఆల్ దట్ మీన్స్ దట్ ది జ్ఞేయం ఈజ్ నాట్ హ్యావింగ్ ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్. జ్ఞేయం ఈజ్ ఓన్లీ కేపబుల్ ఆఫ్ అపియరింగ్ యాజ్ ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్. జ్ఞేయం ఈజ్ నాట్ రియలీ హ్యావింగ్ దీస్ థింగ్స్, ఇట్ ఈస్ కేపబుల్ ఆఫ్ అపియరింగ్ యాజ్ ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్. సో ఇన్ దట్ సెన్స్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్. సో ఈజ్ ఇట్ క్లియర్? వేర్ ఈజ్ ఇట్? ఇత్యేవం ప్రదర్శనార్థః నతు సాక్షాదేవ జవనాది క్రియావత్వ ప్రదర్శనార్థః. ఇట్ ఈస్ యు సీ నతు సాక్షాత్, సాక్షాత్ మీన్స్ డైరెక్ట్లీ. ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ యాజ్ దో దట్ బ్రహ్మన్ ఈజ్ హ్యావింగ్ దట్ జవనాది క్రియావత్వం. ఓకే, ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ ఏబుల్ టు మూవ్, ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ ఏబుల్ టు రన్ సే 10 kilometers స్పీడ్, సో దట్ బ్రహ్మన్ ఈజ్ ఏబుల్ టు రన్ సే 100 kilometers స్పీడ్. ఇట్స్ నాట్ లైక్ దట్. ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ హ్యావింగ్ దట్ జవనాది క్రియావత్వం. ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ ఎ క్రియావాన్. నిష్క్రియం, యు సీ దెర్ ఇస్ నో యాక్టివిటీ ఇన్ దట్. సో దట్ ఈస్ వై జవనాది క్రియావత్వ ప్రదర్శనార్థ. ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ దట్ సెంటెన్స్ ఈజ్ నాట్ టు డెమాన్స్ట్రేట్ ఆర్ టు షో దట్ బ్రహ్మన్ ఈజ్ హ్యావింగ్ ఆల్ దీస్ క్రియాస్ ఇన్ ఇట్. అపాణిపాదం జవన గ్రహీత ఎట్సెట్రా ఎట్సెట్రా, దట్ సెంటెన్స్ ఈజ్ ఓన్లీ టు షో దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ ది శక్తి టు రిజెంబుల్, ఇట్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ ది శక్తి టు అజ్యూమ్ ది షేప్స్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్ ఆర్ అపియర్ యాజ్ ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్. బట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ దట్ సెంటెన్స్ ఈజ్ నాట్ టు షో దట్ దట్ జ్ఞేయం ఈజ్ రియలీ హ్యావింగ్ ఆల్ దీస్ క్యారెక్టరిస్టిక్స్. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ ఇట్. దెన్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో గివింగ్ ఎన్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్. అంధో మణిమ అవిందత్ ఇత్యాది మంత్రార్థవత్ తస్య మంత్రస్య అర్థః. సో దిట్ సీమ్స్ దేర్ ఇస్ సమ్ మంత్ర ఇన్ సమ్ ప్లేస్. అంధో మణిమ అవిందత్, అంధః మీన్స్ ఎ బ్లైండ్ మ్యాన్, మణిమ్ అవిందత్ హీ సా ఎ మణి, హీ సా ఎ డైమండ్. హౌ కెన్ ఎ అంధ సీ డైమండ్? హౌ కెన్ ఎ బ్లైండ్ మ్యాన్ సీ ఎ డైమండ్? సో ఇన్ దట్ కాంటెక్స్ట్ So and that mantra fully, that full mantra is not mentioned here, but in commentary somewhere it is mentioned. Say blind man, he sees a money, and then somebody who is not having fingers, so he wore that money like a ring. He made a ring and wore it on his finger. And then somebody who does not have the power of speech, a dumb person. So he described that money. So all this, that full mantra is like that. It is something which is only an imagination. It is only imagination. It is not real. So in that sense, this money, this mantra has to be understood, the above mantra, and not in any other sense, not as a real thing. So that is what Shankaracharya says. Andhomani mavindatu ityadi mantrarthavat. So just as that andhomani mavindat, etc., is something like an arthavada, the above mantra also has to be understood like that. Then, yasmat, sarvakarana varjitam jnayam, तस्माद् असक्तम् सर्वसंश्लेष वर्जितम् यद्यप्येवम् तथापि सर्वभृत् चैव. Okay, then we have come to the next word. So we have completed सर्वेन्द्रिय गुणाभासं सर्वेन्द्रिय विवर्जितम्. We have completed. We are now coming to असक्तम्. Yasmat sarvakarana varjitam jnayam, because this jnayam is devoid of any of these karanams, any of these indriyas, then that is why it is called asaktam. Tasmat means therefore asaktam. It is not connected with anything. It is not, that is why it is called asaktam. Then sarva samshlesha varjitam. Samshlesha, you know, samshlesha means to be together. Shlesha, shlisha, shlisha dhatu, to be yoked, to be combined, to be joined with something else. Sarva samshlesha vajit, there is no contact with anything. Sarva samshlesha varjitam, devoid of any contact. Even then, yadyapi evam means, even though it is so, yadyapi evam, even though it is so, tathapi, even then, sarvabhrut chaiva, it is sarvabhrut, it is the supporter of all. How is the supporter of all? He is explaining. सदास्पदं हि सर्वं सर्वत्र सद्बुद्ध्यनुगतं सद्बुद्ध्यनुगमात्. सो सदास्पदं हि सर्वं सर्वत्र सर्वं सर्वत्र एव्रीथिंग एव्रीवेयर. सर्वं सर्वत्र मीन्स एव्रीथिंग एव्रीवेयर. इट इज बेस्ड ऑन और इट इज सपोर्टेड बाय सम सॉर्ट ऑफ रियलिटी ओनली. सो सपोज यू सी ए स्नेक. So that snake either should be real, or it should be something superimposed on a snake, on a rope, isn't it? So there is something which is a substratum. There is something which is a base, which is a substratum on which something is based. So sarvam sarvatrahi sadaspadam. Aspadam means adharam. You can note down, aspadam means adharam. Sadaspadam means it is based or supported. Aspadam means adharam. It is based or supported by something which is real. Sarvam sarvatra sadaspadam sadbuddhyanugamat. That means it is associated with this buddhi, sadbuddhi. Sadbuddhi means it exists, it exists, it exists. So everywhere you see, it exists, it exists, it exists. So that buddhi is continuing in everything. So I think the time is over. We'll continue in the next class. ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते. ॐ शान्तिः शान्तिः शान्तिः.